Zapadna Afrika uvozi prljavo gorivo. Zašto? Zapadna Afrika prodaje svoju dobru sirovu naftu. Zašto? Što rade švicarske kompanije koje se bave ovim poslom? Danas je veliki dan za Puma Energy. Ova naftna kompanija osvojila je još dio tržišta goriva u Gani i želi da se to zna. Ovdje su službeni predstavnici, a na poziv se odazvalo nekoliko uglednih osoba. Tu su, naravno, i mediji. Ministar prometa svečano će pustiti u promet ove cisterne kerozina. Budući da je aerodrom blizu, služit će za opskrbu aviona. To je strateški važno za Ganu koja se želi nametnuti kao sila u usponu u ovom dijelu svijeta. Novinare vode dalje u obilazak uz jaku pratnju i bez jednog slobodnog trenutka. Iduća je postaja ova potpuno nova benzinska crpka u bojama Puma Energy. Tvrtka ima 41 crpku u Gani. To nije mnogo, ali Puma Energy ima velike apetite.
Puma Energy's Oyarifa service station.
We are serving clean fuel to our motorists. So anytime you have the chance to come by, pass by, fill up your tank, and you are sure that you have clean fuel in your vehicle, you wouldn't have any problem whatsoever.
Što je rekao?
And you are sure that you have clean fuel in your vehicle.
Čisto. Ovi su spremnici sigurno čisti. Ali gorivo, to se odnosi na razinu sumpora i izražava se jedinicom ppm dijelovima na milijun. Dopuštenu granicu određuje svaka država za sebe. U Švicarskoj i Europi granica za dizel iznosi 10 ppm-a. U Gani je ta granica 3000 ppm-a. Taj je dizel tako prljav da bi njegova prodaja kod nas bila zabranjena. Što o tome misli šef Puma Energy?
Vous savez qu'au Ghana, le standard n'est pas très élevé,
Correct.
Notamment en termes de soufre.
Oui.
Vous êtes au courant de cela?
On est complètement au courant et c'est valable pour beaucoup de pays en Afrique. Même si on regarde dans un super grand marché comme l'Afrique du Sud, même là, les spécifications, ils vous souffrent, sont encore plus élevées que beaucoup de marchés.
Au Ghana, le maximum autorisé est 3000
oui.
ppm. C'est beaucoup.
C'est beaucoup, ouais.
Vous êtes d'accord qu'en termes de santé, ça pose un problème?
Ça pose des problèmes, notamment, comme je dis, notre but comme Puma, c'est s'aligner avec d'abord les spécifications du pays. Et si on peut, notamment, on essaye d'améliorer en fait les produits qu'on importe.
Trude se biti bolji. Jedna švicarska nevladina organizacija tvrdi da je to laž.
Il y a aujourd'hui une stratégie délibérée de la part des négociants suisses en pétrole qui est de jouer sur la faiblesse des standards de carburant qui prévaut en Afrique en délivrant une bonne qualité de carburant en Europe et à l'inverse, en délivrer des produits de très mauvaise qualité, très sales en Afrique.
En même temps, tout ce qu'ils font est parfaitement légal.
C'est vrai, c'est parfaitement légal, c'est dans les limites admissibles. À notre sens, il est tout à fait inacceptable que les négociants suisses de pétrole profitent de la faiblesse de la régulation en Afrique pour faire des profits aux dépens de millions d'individus.
Dakle, Public Eye optužuje ih da im je to namjerna strategija. Njihova istraga usredotočila se na švicarske kompanije za trgovinu naftom, prije svega na Trafiguru, čija je afrička podružnica Puma Energy, te na Vitol, čiji su partneri u Africi, Vivo Energy i Shell. To su divovske tvrtke. Trafigura ima prihod od gotovo 100 milijardi dolara, to je više od Nestlea. Ostvaruje dobit od 2,6 milijardi. Vitol je super teška kategorija, prihod im iznosi 168 milijardi dolara. Više od toga ne znamo, podaci su povjerljivi. Švicarska je važan igrač u ovom poslu. 35% svjetske trgovine naftom prolazi kroz Ženevu.
C'est un fait qui est peu connu. Les compagnies suisses de négoce de pétrole sont présentes à tous les niveaux de la chaîne. Donc elles sont présentes au niveau de la fabrication des carburants. Et puis, c'est un phénomène qui est assez récent, depuis 5 ou 6 ans. Les négociants suisses de pétrole ont racheté et respectivement construit des réseaux de stations-service en Afrique.
My name is Mark. I am from Switzerland. Yeah. Yeah, diesel for this one, please. Yeah.
Dok je istraživao, Margenija obišao je te benzinske crpke. Uzeo uzorke goriva u 8 afričkih zemalja. Analiza je pokazala da je razina sumpora u dizelu i do 300 puta veća nego kod nas. Tri je godine provodio istraživanje za švicarsku nevladinu organizaciju Public Eye, bivšu Declaration de Bern, koja je poznata po tome što javno govori o trgovini sirovinama. Ovoga puta zaronili su u dvostruko zatvoreni svijet nafte i trgovaca.
Les négociants suisses de pétrole, l'opacité fait partie de leur modèle d'affaires. C'est des sociétés qui sont extrêmement discrètes par nature, qui apparaissent très peu vis-à-vis du grand public, à l'exception peut-être de leur station-service, mais encore, elles opèrent sous d'autres noms. Par ailleurs, ce sont des sociétés privées qui ne sont pas cotées en bourse, qui sont détenues par leurs managers. Les managers sont les principaux actionnaires de ces sociétés, ce qui fait qu'elles n'ont pas de compte à rendre vis-à-vis de petits porteurs dans le cadre d'assemblées générales, ou alors elles ne sont pas soumises à la loi sur les bourses. Finalement, elles ne répondent qu'à elles-mêmes.
Tjednima smo e-mailom pokušavali stupiti u kontakt s Trafigurom. Nažalost, izbjegavali su naša pitanja. Nisu htjeli razgovarati s nama ni telefonom i na kraju su odbili svaku mogućnost intervjua. Umjesto toga uputili su nas na svoju internetsku stranicu na kojoj je sadržaj očito promotivan.
Imamo svjetsku mrežu koja nam omogućuje da sve usluge koje pružamo budu vrlo kvalitetne. Uvozimo rafinirane naftne derivate koji su potrebni Africi. Gdje god smo prisutni, primjenjujemo najviše standarde kvalitete. Pazimo da nam glavna briga pri donošenju odluka budu zdravlje, sigurnost i okolište, skrb o zajednicama u kojima radimo. Trafigura. Mijenjamo trgovačku kulturu u Africi.
Vitol nam je pak dao lakonski odgovor.
Vitol i Vivo Energy poštuju i primjenjuju regulative svih jurisdikcija u kojima posluju. Prema ganskim zakonima, Vitol ne smije izravno opskrbljivati Vivo Energy naftnim proizvodima. Vivo Energy mora se snabdijevati uvozničkoj komori, koju kompaniji opskrbljuju proizvodima koji su u skladu s lokalnim zakonima.
Da podcrtamo, imamo strahovito moćne švicarske kompanije koje Zapadnu Afriku opskrbljuju gorivom koje se kod nas ne bi smjelo prodavati i to je legalno. Ali kako je to moguće? Istraga nas vodi u naftne luke Amsterdam i Rotterdam. Nije nam dugo trebalo da shvatimo koliko su naftni krugovi zatvoreni.
I sent the email a few days ago and I didn't receive an answer yet. I sent it to media nl@shell.com.
U Zapadnoj Africi izabrali smo Ganu jer u toj državi švicarske kompanije sudjeluju u cijelom procesu, od proizvodnje nafte do distribucije.
To je short limits.
There are other companies that have their own pipeline here.
Kako nam švicarske kompanije ne žele odgovoriti? Oduševljeni smo što smo uspjeli dogovoriti razgovor s predstavnikom stranih uvoznika u Gani. Ganski zakon zahtjeva da stranim tvrtkama za uvoz goriva predstavnik bude neka lokalna tvrtka. Te tvrtke okupljene su u središnjici čiji je predsjednik Senio Hosi. Odmah potvrđuje da su švicarske kompanije zaista u Gani, ali su u Sjeni.
Trafigura, Vitor, they are moving huge volumes into Ghana. All right, we are very dependent on their services, and I have to say they've been significantly professional. Glencore too is here. You have British Petroleum also here.
If they are investing in Ghana, it means that it's good business.
It's good business. I mean, it's good business. So that influence has been very, very, very positive. Trafigura, I think some 10 years ago, made about a $50 million investment in a facility that enabled us to get vessels in sea and get products on shore through some pipelines.
To je dobar primjer švicarske prisutnosti. Ove platforme za pristajanje brodova smještene su na moru nedaleko od Teme, luke ganskoga glavnoga grada. Sagradila ih je Trafigura 2006. i njima upravlja njihova podružnica Puma Energy Ghana, koja je napola švicarska, napola ganska, baš kao što i treba biti. Takva infrastruktura omogućuje velikim brodovima s gazom dubljim od 10 metara da iskrcaju naftne proizvode bez pristajanja uz obalu.
That was very critical for Ghana. Other than that, would have had logistical constraints in making products available. So that has been constructive, I mean, for us.
Kompanija je s Ganom sklopila ugovor na 10 godina. Uložila je ovu infrastrukturu i održavala ju je. Najviše ju upotrebljavala za pristajanje svojih tankera, naplaćujući pritom taksu konkurentskim brodovima. Ove platforme pripale su državi Gani u kolovozu 2016. Takav dogovor svima odgovara, ali ne rješava problem kvalitete uvezenoga goriva. Sad smo taknuli u osjetljivu temu.
I can't tell you that in Ghana it's one of the lowest.
It's not the lowest, it's not the highest.
Standard in the world, in Ghana.
It's not the worst.
It's not the worst.
Standards are...
Okay, 3,000 ppm, I say it.
You are right, 3,000 ppm.
Okay,
you are very bad. Right. It's not great. 3,000 ppm is not great. And we all agree it's not great. It's a discussion that we have had last year, and it's a discussion that we think should translate to real action in the coming year.
A dotle stanovnici Gane kašlju. Sumporni dioksid koji izlazi iz ispušnih cijevi uvlači se u sve. Već je odavno poznato da ima izravan utjecaj na astmu, upale dišnih putova, pa čak i na krvožilne bolesti. Nedavno je Svjetska zdravstvena organizacija čak potvrdila vezu između sumpornog dioksida i raka pluća. U Africi, nažalost, ima i prečih problema. Siromaštvo, malarija i ebola na pragu su Gane. Tako da kvaliteta zraka nije prioritet. Kad pitate ulične prodavače, oni se zbog toga ne uzrujavaju, iako stalno žive u tom onečišćenju.
We know the problems. If it's when you pass, the air that blows, it comes to redirect our nose direct.
Yes.
So all the time we fall sick. Fall sick.
And you stay here the whole day?
We stay here all day. This is our station. Mm. Oh, sorry, we are working here. Mm. You see, these big trucks are passing with blowing air to our nose. You see, we get problem.
Sometimes we used to cough because the hair is not good for us. So,
I believe they said that we should not smoke because of the heart of the cancer. But this hair soda is coming out from the car. It's not suitable for the heart, you understand? But if you take it, he said it will come dark in your heart, in front of your heart. So that one, only many sickness is coming. Many sickness that is coming.
And you stay how long every day near the road?
Yeah, for me, I will come here like 4 o'clock a.m. Then I'll close like 8 o'clock p.m. So most of the night.
4 o'clock in the morning?
In the morning.
Until 8 o'clock in the evening?
Yeah. Do every day. I've been here for almost 6 years now.
Ghana se počela baviti problemom onečišćenja u Akri.
Kwaku? Is it far away from here at Shimota?
Shimota. About 1 hour.
1 hour?
Yeah.
Needs 1 hour to go.
Ashimota je vrlo prometno raskrižje. Ganska je agencija za zaštitu okoliša na njega 2014. postavila mjerač kvalitete zraka. U Akri ih je postavljeno 30, a rezultati mjerenja objavljeni su u izvještaju u svibnju 2015. Molili smo agenciju za zaštitu okoliša da nam pošalje najnovije rezultate, ali u zadnji čas. Imamo rezultate razina sumpora iz svibnja 2015. To je tema našeg filma. Hvala vam na pomoći.
Vidjet ću s kolegom.
Možemo li se sutra naći na razgovoru? Hvala.
Mislimo da je za ovu temu nadležno Državno povjerenstvo za naftu. Agencija za zaštitu okoliša ne može vas primiti na razgovor sutra u ponedjeljak. Hvala.
Važno nam je da saznamo najnovije podatke, pa sami pokušavamo doći do njih.
We are looking for measure instruments if somewhere should be around.
U očaju čak pitamo prolaznike. Imamo fotografije iz tih famoznih izvještaja.
Maybe the picture is an illustration for the whole work. But don't look the rest of the picture because it's not really. Možda su mjerače uklonili ili premjestili. Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye.
Have a nice evening. Thank you. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
Moramo se zadovoljiti rezultatima iz 2014. I oni već zabrinjavaju. U zraku ima i više nego previše sumpora, kao i previše sitnih čestica. Da bismo bolje shvatili kako stoje stvari, trebamo nešto za usporedbu. Kakvo je stanje u Ženevi?
Le point principal de la station en fait c'est le tube en verre renversé que vous voyez qui est un captage de l'air. D'accord. Donc le principe de la station c'est on capte un échantillon d'air et ensuite on l'analyse à l'intérieur.
Okay.
On fait une analyse chimique sur les polluants qui sont présents à ce niveau-là dans la station.
Mais une petite question qui m'intrigue, c'est on n'est pas dans un quartier très avec beaucoup de monde. Pourquoi avoir choisi cet endroit-là ?
C'est une très bonne question. C'est parce que nous, on regarde la pollution de fond. Donc on ne recherche pas forcément l'endroit où il y a le plus. Évidemment, si on se met en bordure d'autoroute, par exemple, on va avoir beaucoup plus de polluants qu'ici. Par contre, ici, on est représentatif d'une pollution de fond moyenne dans un milieu urbain. Parce que certes, ici, il n'y a pas beaucoup de circulation, mais tout autour, on est sur des axes passablement chargés et donc très représentatifs du milieu urbain.
C'est installé depuis quand, cet appareil ?
Depuis 3 ans maintenant, ici, à cet endroit, rue Necker. Le principe, il est assez simple. On prend un échantillon d'air, c'est le tube que vous voyez ici, qui amène cet échantillon dans les instruments, qui font une analyse physico-chimique, alors, dioxyde de soufre, bien sûr, mais aussi, par exemple, le méthane, le monoxyde de carbone, le dioxyde de soufre qu'on retrouve ici, et les oxydes d'azote. Il y a aussi les particules fines.
C'est celle-là qui nous pose le plus de soucis.
Alors oui, actuellement, les particules fines, l'ozone et les oxydes d'azote sont les polluants problématiques dans nos régions, notamment au milieu urbain.
Alors que le soufre ?
Le soufre, aujourd'hui, n'est plus un problème. Ici, je peux vous montrer l'évolution depuis 1986 jusqu'à nos jours des concentrations annuelles de dioxyde de soufre, telles qu'elles sont mesurées à Genève. Donc on voit que dans les années 80, les émissions étaient extrêmement importantes et les concentrations mesurées étaient au-dessus de la valeur légale. Et puis par contre, depuis maintenant plus de 20 ans, nous sommes à des niveaux très très bas.
Comment on est arrivé à tel résultat ?
Alors on est arrivé à tel résultat avec des normes sur les carburants et les combustibles qui n'ont cessé de se renforcer depuis les années 70 à peu près.
Dakle, to traje već desetljećima, zato što je sumpor škodljiv.
C'est déjà un irritant pour les voies respiratoires, la peau, les yeux notamment, en termes d'impact sur la santé de la population. Ça a aussi un impact environnemental via les pluies acides qu'on a connues il y a plusieurs dizaines d'années dans nos régions.
Alors nous, notre enquête elle nous a conduit au Ghana. Et c'est vrai que là-bas, on a pu constater que les normes sont extrêmement différentes. Si je vous dis que là-bas, le standard pour le diesel, c'est 3000 ppm.
Énorme. Enorme, 3000 ppm.
Tu je i pitanje sitnih čestica. Pokazujemo mu podatke iz ganskog izvještaja.
Qu'est-ce que vous en pensez?
Oui, alors on a des taux extrêmement élevés, hein, ponctuels de concentration en microgrammes par mètre cube qui atteignent 800, 850, 900 même microgrammes par mètre cube. Pour donner un ordre de grandeur, ici à Genève, à partir de 50 microgrammes par mètre cube, on commence à prendre des mesures dites d'urgence pour essayer de limiter les excursions de particules fines dans l'atmosphère.
U Gani 900 microgrammes.
Ici à Genève, à partir de 50 microgrammes par mètre cube, on commence à prendre des mesures dites d'urgence.
Država mora odrediti zakonske granice, kako u Švicarskoj i u afričkim državama. Zašto Ghana i dalje ima normu od 3000 ppm za dizel?
I would like to talk to Judith, please. She is the assistant of the executive director. Is it possible, please? Thank you.
Ovo pitanje pokušavamo uputiti ganskim vlastima.
Hello, is it Judith? No, she's not here. And is the doctor available? Can I talk to him? He's busy. Judith has already all the details. We sent an email, she printed the letter, and we just need to reach the director now, please. So this is quite urgent. Thank you for your help.
Riješite se glavobolje prije nego postane jaka. Uzmite Lekadol na vrijeme. Od sada, u novom pakiranju. Čim osjetite bol, uzmite Lekadol. Prije upotrebe pažljivo pročitajte uputu o lijeku, a o rizicima i nuspojavama upitajte svog liječnika ili ljekarnika.
Na ovo su čekali svi u Hrvatskoj. Sada, do 80% likvidacijski popust u Galeriji Tepiha. Trešnjevka iza Ciboninog tornja. Više na galerijatepiha.hr.
Još 5 dana, do definitivnog kraja.
Odvojite vrijeme za sebe i svoje zdravlje. Odlazak na redovite mamografske preglede spašava život. Odazovite se na nacionalni program ranog otkrivanja raka dojke.
Komplicirano je, zato ćemo pokušati drugčije. Energy, podružnica švicarske kompanije Trafigura, organizira inauguralnu svečanost u jednom od najluksuznijih hotela u Akri. U programu je najavljeno nekoliko vrlo visokih državnih dužnosnika. E da, došao je i ministar za naftu. Očito se dobro brinu za njega.
Gives me great pleasure to be part of this very important event. Today's momentous event comes in the wake of Ghana's remarkable stride towards economic transformation. And we wish you all the best.
Čim je izašao, pokušali smo ga intervjuirati. Htjeli smo iscrpani intervju na nekome mirnom mjestu kako bismo čuli njegove argumente o kvaliteti goriva na crpkama i eventualnoj odgovornosti švicarskih kompanija koje prodaju prljave proizvode u njegovoj zemlji. Bio je ovo naš prvi i posljednji susret. Izvještaj Public Eye-a otkrio je da se sve uklapa u vrlo dobro promišljen poslovni model.
Les négociants suisses de pétrole délivrent et vendent des produits pétroliers en Afrique, mais également les fabriquent à travers un procédé qu'on appelle en anglais le blending, c'est littéralement mélanger différentes qualités de carburant. Et l'idée sous-jacente à cette stratégie commerciale, c'est de fabriquer cette qualité africaine de carburant en détériorant sciemment la qualité des produits pour être au plus près des limites légales en vigueur en Afrique.
Što je on to rekao o gorivu?
En détériorant sciemment la qualité des produits pour être au plus près des limites légales en vigueur en Afrique.
Objasnit ćemo vam. Postupak rafiniranja sirove nafte sličan je destilaciji. Sirovina se zagrijava i ovisno o temperaturi iz nje se dobivaju različite sastavne tvari, od čišćih prema prljavijima. Najprije je ukapljeni naftni plin za plinske boce. Zatim gorivo za automobile ili nafta za proizvodnju plastike. Nakon toga dolazi kerozin za avione. Zatim dizel, drugo gorivo za automobile i kamione. Zatim loživo ulje za generatore i bazno ulje. I zatim teško ulje koje je puno sumpora. Kompanije koje trguju naftom jeftino kupuju ta teška ulja. Zatim, kao prema kuharskom receptu, dodaju sastojke s manje sumpora kako bi za što nižu cijenu dobili što više goriva koje će biti točno unutar zakonskih granica i odobrenih standarda. Kao što smo već vidjeli, ti su standardi vrlo niski i zovu se afrička kvaliteta. Pitanja je mnogo. Odgovore ćemo potražiti u takozvanoj regiji ARA, što je kratica za Amsterdam, Rotterdam, Antwerpen. To je područje jedno od epicentara proizvodnje naftnih proizvoda.
Is the blending legal?
Het mengen van stoffen is op zichzelf heel legaal. Wat niet legaal is, is het mengen van afvalstoffen met stoffen. Die afvalstoffen moeten worden afgegeven aan een erkende verwerker van afvalstoffen en mogen niet zomaar worden gemengd met andere stoffen.
Renske Makor je tužiteljica u Rotterdamu, članica je stručnog tima Andatea, nizozemskog projekta u kojem pravosuđe i policija zajednički sudjeluju u borbi protiv ekoloških zločina. Oni se najviše bave brodskim gorivom, najvećim onečišćivačem od svih goriva. Princip je uvijek isti. Kako bi se mogli prodati, naftni proizvodi moraju slijediti protokol. U Europi je to direktiva koja se zove REACH, koja zahtjeva od trgovaca da upišu svoje proizvode u bazu podataka kako bi dobili nešto što se može usporediti s osobnom iskaznicom. Problem je u tome što je ta procedura toliko komplicirana da je nitko nije potpuno svladao, a neke kompanije to iskorištavaju. Tužiteljica to dobro zna.
Voor ons, vanuit het perspectief van de handhaving, strafrechtelijke handhaving, biedt REACH uitdagingen. Dat ziet op dat het juridisch complex is, maar het is ook chemisch complex.
Can we talk about greenwashing?
Wat wij zien vanuit onze onderzoeken is dat we vermoeden dat bedrijven REACH, want daar gaat het eigenlijk om, de wetgeving gebruiken om eigenlijk afvalstoffen om te katten naar product. Dus dat er gebruik wordt gemaakt van misschien wel de mogelijkheden die REACH biedt om onder de afvalstoffenwetgeving uit te komen. En wat wij zien is dat in dit soort zaken er twee keer winst wordt behaald. Namelijk dat afvalstoffen niet worden afgevoerd naar een erkende verwerker, wat geld kost. Maar dat ze worden gemengd met een product, dus eigenlijk verdwijnen. Dat is besparing van kosten, dat is de één. En twee is, er wordt ook geld verdiend met meer brandstof. De afvalstoffen komen erbij, wordt verkocht als product en daar wordt geld mee verdiend. Dus dat is twee keer winst. In onderzoeken als deze richten we ons dus ook met name ook zeker op die illegale winsten. En proberen we dat later af te pakken.
Već dugo nas muči još jedno pitanje.
Is it possible to produce a petroleum product that is forbidden to be sold in the country and then to export it in another country when it's not forbidden? Is it possible to do that? Is it legal?
Ja, dat is op zich mogelijk. Dat hier bijvoorbeeld in Nederland een product wordt geproduceerd met een te hoog gehalte van het een of het ander, wat dus hier niet mag worden gebruikt, maar wel in Azië of Afrika.
There is no ethical problem with that?
Er kan een ethisch probleem zijn, maar dat is niet waar wij op zien. Wij kijken naar de juridische kanten van de zaak.
Etičkim problemom bavi se Public Eye. Marijeta Harđono upoznala se sa svim tajnama miješanja naftnih proizvoda. Već je prije uronila u labirint trgovine naftom, ali za Greenpeace, tijekom afere koja se dogodila prije 10 godina. To je bio skandal na brodu Probo Koala. Što je radio taj golemi tanker koji je unajmila švicarska kompanija Trafigura? To pitanje zaintrigiralo je Public Eye. U ono doba, 2006. znalo se samo da se brod htio riješiti toksičnog otpada koji je ostao nakon čišćenja spremnika. Brod je mjesecima pristajao u razne luke, među ostalima i u Amsterdamsku, a onda je odlučio da će nezgodan teret istovariti u obali Bjelokosti.
They came to Amsterdam. Here they were able to actually get it processed in a proper way. But they rejected that option because they thought it was too expensive. So they brought again the waste with them, and so they decided to dump it in West Africa.
How much expensive?
I think it was around $500,000 that they had to pay.
And for Trafigura, is it a lot?
Nothing.
Toksični otpad povjeren je maloj tvrtki iz obale Bjelokosti koja ga je bacila nehajući kako i kamo. Sanitarne posljedice bile su goleme. Razboljelo se 100.000 stanovnika obale Bjelokosti, a 17 ih je umrlo od trovanja. Ni godinu dana poslije švicarska tvrtka Trafigura pregovara s predsjednikom obale Bjelokosti. Obali Bjelokosti isplaćuju odštetu od 240 milijuna švicarskih franaka.
Ma preoccupation, c'est que le peuple soit dédommagé. C'est que l'État soit dédommagé. Ce sont mes deux préoccupations. Or, nos amis du groupe Trafigura ont accédé à nos demandes.
Obala Bjelokosti odbila je podnijeti kaznenu prijavu Međunarodnom sudu, a švicarska kompanija Trafigura i dalje nijekala bilo kakvu odgovornost u tom slučaju. Direktor Trafigure u to doba rekao je:
First of all, neither the state of Ivory Coast nor Trafigura accept any liability for the events which happened last August. And the main element of this agreement is to help the state of Ivory Coast financially. The president spoke tonight on television and clearly said we have to turn the page.
Yeah, turning the page. Accept no liability, corporate responsibility. All these words that he's using, I mean, that's really the words of a company that doesn't take any responsibility, doesn't self-reflect upon their own acts. And turning the page, maybe for them it's easy, but not for the people that have been exposed.
Ove godine 50.000 žrtava iz obale Bjelokosti traži pravdu. U Nizozemskoj su podnijeli kolektivnu kaznenu prijavu protiv Trafigure. Postupak je u tijeku. Prije nego što su očistili spremnike na brodu Probokoala, miješali su se nekvalitetni naftni proizvodi. Public Eye je to otkrio, a istraga te nevladine organizacije pokazala je prije svega da je takav postupak sustavan.
Blending is very common and legal, but what is illegitimate in our eyes is if you blend, if you mix, you make a product that is of bad quality, that you make it on purpose. There's even software for it, where you can actually see like what is the most profitable mix we can make. And this is a practice that we see happening, for example, in the port of Amsterdam, but also in the port of Antwerp, but also on board tankers, is a business model that's actually focused on making a lot of profit.
Stručnjakinja Public Eye naglašava činjenicu da namjerno proizvode nekvalitetne proizvode. Amsterdamska i Rotterdamska luka smatraju se čvorištima u kojima se redovito obavlja takvo miješanje.
One of the key reasons why it's such a big hub is because it has 10 refineries in the area and massive storage capacity. And it also has a very strategic position for the west coast of Africa. So that's why you also see that all the imports in West Africa, for the health, it's coming from the Ara region.
Amsterdamska je luka naravno pod nadzorom države, ali otkrili smo da su terminali vlasništvo privatnih kompanija koje strogo čuvaju podatke svojih klijenata.
So
it's impossible to go inside here.
Yes. There's no official information, and it's also very secretive trading industry. Also the terminals don't want to disclose the clients to which they are renting their tanks.
U Nizozemskoj postoji slabo poznat zakon koji omogućuje građanima da dobiju na uvid popise uskladištenih opasnih tvari. Marijeta se strpljivo poziva na njega na svakom amsterdamskom terminalu.
Sometimes they don't want to make copy, so I just sit, but then I can make notes. And sometimes we were able to, despite the fact that there's no official information, we were able to identify some real cases where we saw that Swiss chartered tankers actually were loading gasoline and diesel for the African markets, and we were able to find a blend recipe. This is the way we were able to see as well, like how dirty the products were that are being sent to Africa.
Odvela nas je na jedno od rijetkih mjesta u Amsterdamskoj luci gdje možemo malo bliže prići tankerima.
How long does it take for big tankers like this to load everything?
It depends a little bit on how big the tanker is, but it could easily be like 18 hours or 20 hours. And they're loading, especially when they're blending, while they're loading, it's the flows come from different tanks.
Yeah.
So they start with one, and then the next one will be flowing. You see the whole infrastructure.
Yeah, this is interesting.
Yeah, you can call it like highways and national roads and small roads, but it's this makes the blending or the loading
pipeline,
very efficient.
Right?
Yeah.
Okay, so and in each pipeline you have different products.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, and it could be that those two tankers are actually commuting. They call it jetty to jetty.
Uh huh.
And maybe then if they would be commuting and they're using the infrastructure of the terminal, sometimes you see two tankers beside each other, and then they're only doing ship-to-ship operations. So they don't use the infrastructure, but they just are laying along the berth.
Pitamo je, ima li danas brodova koje su unajmile švicarske kompanije i koji idu za Zapadnu Afriku?
I checked my databases to see like what ships are in the port today. These two ones, they're called Plutus and Northern Light. They just came from the US, but we see that they regularly trade with West Africa to Lomé or to Lagos, Nigeria.
Marijeta si je na mobitel skinula aplikaciju koja je omogućuje da vizualizira pomorski promet u svim lukama na svijetu, uključujući i Amsterdamsku.
And all the little spots, the red ones are actually means tankers, so you can see there's a lot of tankers, And we are here. You can see that Plutus is here. So let's see what they actually, what information they give. So they give the picture of the ship. See, it's a crude oil tanker. Many times you can see like a little bit the vessel track where the ship has been. And then you can see it's the flag of the tanker is from Bahamas. It's 230 meters length almost. It's in port.
Okay, but nothing about the owner or the people that rent?
No. What is very difficult is to find out like who's actually renting the tanker, who's owning the cargo. And of course, these are the most interesting people because they are instructing the tanker to what to do, where to go, what to blend.
It's not a public information at all.
No, it's a shipping intelligence database where you have to pay for as well. So it's, but it's the only way to get some more information about it.
Više od ovoga nećemo saznati, ali publika je došao do tih informacija.
The Swiss companies. Maybe a dozen smaller ones, but also like the big ones, like Vito, Trafigura, Adax, Mercuria, are very big in this business model. Actually, they're very good at it. They are very good in creating this very bad quality fuels. And it is because they are present all along the supply chain, so they have storage capacity in strategic locations in many different places. They even have refineries. They even have, well, they have access to hundreds of tankers. So they are able to collect all those different intermediate products and to use it whenever it's most profitable for them. And they can earn a lot of money with it.
Tu je i dodatni element. Većina zemalja Zapadne Afrike ima sirovu naftu na svome tlu. Neke čak imaju i rafinerije. Public Eye upozorava javnost i na to.
C'est un paradoxe de constater que ces pays producteurs de pétrole à faible teneur en soufre l'exportent dans différentes régions du monde, notamment en Europe, et ils reçoivent en retour des carburants très dangereux pour la santé.
Zašto zemlje poput Gane uvozi loše gorivo ako ima kvalitetnu sirovu naftu? Tim više što ima i rafineriju.
That's good. So we make the interview and we need also to make the shooting at the refinery. Okay. Okay, that's fine. All right, thank you. Bye.
To je bonne nouvelle.
Dobra je vijest to što sad izravno možemo nekoga pitati zašto ganska rafinerija ne opskrbljuje Ganu gorivom. Otkrivamo da je to stara državna rafinerija sagrađena 1967. Davno prije otkrića naftnih polja 2010. Prije je prerađivala sirovu naftu koja se uvozila iz Nigerije. U svojim najboljim godinama namirivala je i do 50% državne potražnje. Zatim je zapala u dugove i onda se potpuno ugasila i ostavila odriješene ruke privatnim uvoznicima. Rafinerija je opet počela raditi početkom 2016. Financijsku injekciju dobila je liberalizacijom cijena goriva na crpkama i ulaganjima međunarodnih financijskih institucija. Ponovno pokretanje poklopilo se s dolaskom novog direktora.
I'm very bullish about this refinery. When we came in July last year, they said it couldn't be done. They said we couldn't run it for more than 3 weeks and it would break down. We've been running it continuously since the 4th of February this year, after we made certain adjustments, and it's working perfectly. We are getting better than expected yields on all the imports that we've done. We've finished refining our first million barrels. We made a decent profit on it. Our second million barrels is currently what is being run at the moment. And we've booked our third cargo.
So the old lady is working well.
The old lady is working well, but she's going to get better because there are certain adjustments that we have to make that are being made. So the old lady is doing well and she's going to get better.
To je službeno stajalište ganske vlade. Sve je dobro. S druge je strane Senio Hossi, koji zastupa interese uvoznika, dakle i švicarskih kompanija za trgovinu naftom. On sumnja u to da će državna rafinerija uspjeti dobro poslovati.
Politicians, in my opinion, are not great businessmen.
Why?
Governance is more of a social service. It has a redistributive role. That thinking doesn't run in business. You are looking at profits. You are looking at project viability. You are thinking at the margins when you are a businessman. You are thinking about competition when you are the businessman. The politician is not thinking about competition in terms of business. They're talking about competition in terms of votes. The two of them are not the same. Okay, so refinery is real business, and it would be viable when government takes itself out of it. It will also be viable when we have Swiss investors, with all that you can do, to rather be investing in refineries in Ghana.
Pa ipak, rafinerija proizvodi 45.000 barela na dan. Nije loše za postrojenje na izdahu, a ugodno je iznenađenje i to što su joj proizvodi kvalitetni. To naravno ne odgovara uvoznicima prljavoga goriva.
The truth is that the refined products we make here are better quality than we can ever import. We are producing high grade low sulfur gas oil or diesel. Again, you find out that importers blend and they blend with DPK dual purpose kerosene to get to the right quantity and the right volume and spec. In Ghana, we don't have to do that.
You know that they are making big money, the Swiss traders' companies, with that.
Yeah.
Do you think they won't fight for their territory?
Well, the interesting thing is that we don't see it as a bad thing, because if you are fighting, it means you're competing. And competition is good. That's why I'm very pro-business, I'm very pro-private sector. Because ultimately, if you up the game, because your state companies have upped the game, the private sector will do the same.
Je li to moguće? Primjer za to daje 5 zemalja Istočne Afrike, među kojima je i Kenija. Potkraj 2013. prihvatili su standarde kvalitete goriva koji su bliski švicarskim i europskim normama.
C'est une décision qui a été prise et qui a eu aucun impact sur le prix à la pompe pour les consommateurs, qui a eu aucun impact en termes de rentrée fiscale ou de subvention pour le gouvernement. Ils ont tout simplement réussi à limiter les profits que se faisaient les négociants en délivrant des produits de mauvaise qualité. On a réussi à calculer à travers différentes études qui ont été publiées par des organismes comme la Banque mondiale, par le programme des Nations Unies sur l'environnement, que l'impact à la pompe sur le prix du litre d'essence ou de diesel pour amener cette qualité de carburant au niveau de la qualité européenne est très très faible. C'est 2 centimes par litre d'essence.
2 centa za litru goriva. Pa zar se švicarske kompanije zaista ne mogu potruditi?
Look, take all the Swiss guys who want to do this. They are in for money. Everybody needs to make profits to be able to keep employment and also to be able to post profits to their shareholders, who can also make investments and generate employment elsewhere. So even though you look at profit as money, but that money is actually having an economic value and implication to everybody. So it's not just money, it's an economic situation.
So how are doing the East African countries? They do it.
I mean, Isabella.
It's a political decision?
I absolutely agree with you, it has to be done.
So it's political responsibility?
It's a political decision. And once political decisions are made, businessmen follow. Government wants to deliver price at a certain level. Businessmen can deliver it at that level if the quality is low. And if they decide to keep the quality low, you can't blame the businessman. I think largely that people are not good because it's good to be good. People are actually good because the system compels them to be good.
Public Eye smatra da to nije baš tako jednostavno.
Il y a quand même un lobby organisé des importateurs de carburant au Ghana. C'est un secteur qui est souvent sujet à des conflits d'intérêts entre des politiques et leur entourage qui se mêlent de ces affaires-là, qui sont parfois propriétaires directs ou indirects de sociétés d'importation et qui n'ont pas un intérêt à ce que ça se sache. Donc il y a une certaine velléité de dissimuler des activités qui sont parfois discutables sur le plan de l'éthique dans la conduite des affaires. Les gouvernements africains doivent améliorer leurs standards, mais ça ne signifie pas que les négociants suisses en pétrole ne peuvent pas agir. Ils pourraient commencer dès aujourd'hui, et ils devraient le faire, à délivrer une qualité européenne en Afrique.
I tako, s obzirom na to da ništa nije ilegalno, nevladina organizacija može jedino vršiti pritisak obrušavajući se na ugled švicarskih kompanija za trgovinu naftom. Hoće li one reagirati na to? S afričke strane nazire se drugo rješenje.
For the first time, we are saying that just like you have in Europe, we're going to use market forces to be more efficient, to be more competitive, to drive the standards and the quality up, to protect ourselves. If we don't do that, then all the moral arguments, all the good things that should be done, cannot be done. Because if you don't put yourself in a place where you can outcompete, there's no way you're going to survive because charity is a very risky business.
But the Swiss trading companies, they are not doing charity or philanthropic.
No, they're not doing charity or philanthropy.
And they are exactly coming from this capitalist model, as you said.
They are doing a capitalist model. And if we don't have our own capitalist business model that is able to compete with them, then we are at their mercy.
Ghana se pokušava izboriti. Ne želi više gutati loše gorivo i gledati kako trgovački divovi gomilaju dobit. Htjela bi sudjelovati u plesu u nadi da će ovoga puta ona određivati ritam.